The Tooth Fairy, written by The Gremlin 18. When I was little, my parents used to tell me stories about the Tooth Fairy. True to its name, it was supposed to be a childlike, ethereal creature. A young girl with wings like a butterfly in shimmering colors of blue, green, and gold, with long hair that glowed like the sun. She would dance from house to house during the night in a silver dress, wearing jewel-encrusted slippers. Little boys and girls that lost a tooth would place it under their pillows and wake to find a loony in its place. I was 5 years old at the time, and I just lost my first tooth. My parents encouraged me to place it under my pillow when the time came, enthusing about the trip we would go make to the corner store for a treat. I was skeptical for my age, and I told my parents that I didn't like the idea of a strange girl coming into my room. "Can't I stay up and wait for the Tooth Fairy?" I asked as my mom helped me get into my pajamas. "The Tooth Fairy only comes when you're asleep, dear," she said, ruffling my brown hair and ushering me towards the bed. It was just a plain piece of furniture made out of wood, set low to the floor, and it creaked as I climbed into it. Dad had tried to convince me that I needed a race car bed, but I didn't like cars. Besides, Jesse from school got a race car bed when he was 3. It was a bed meant for babies. "How do you know what the Tooth Fairy looks like if you're always asleep?" I asked. My mom looked down at me, her hands on her hips. A line formed between her brow for a second before she held out her hand, palm up, for the tooth I clutched in mine. "You just know," she said. I grudgingly dropped the tooth into her waiting hand. I watched as she placed it into a little blue satin bag and tucked it under my pillow. I lay back, and she pulled the white and blue striped blankets over my chest. She picked up a small paperback book from the nightstand called Owl at Home and read through the first 2 stories until my eyes began to droop. After she left, my room was plunged into darkness, save for the nightlight that resembles the starry night sky. But the light was of little comfort, as its pale glow failed to reach the end of the room where I slept. I tossed about, my hand reaching under my pillow to brush the soft satin bag, feeling the nub of the tooth within. I eventually fell asleep with the bag clutched to my chest. My body curled up as though to protect this thing that used to be a part of me. I'm not sure how much time passed. The night was still. The air in my room was cool, and all I could hear was the steady sound of my own breathing. I shifted, turning from one side to the other. The bed creaked and groaned softly as I did so. The satin bag was still in my hand, and I sighed. I opened my eyes, still heavy with sleep, my room slowly coming into focus. I could just make out the edges of the intricate mural on my wall, closest to the nightlight and the door. Dad had asked a friend to paint it based on some design that he'd come up with. It was supposed to depict a forest the heroic knight had traveled through to reach the path to the dark castle that stretched towards the corner of the room. Dad said a large dragon lived inside the castle and that it guarded a pile of treasure and a princess. My eyes followed the path to the castle. You were supposed to be able to see the eyes of the dragon within. The castle was dark, and you could barely make out any of the details the further you traveled from the nightlight. I looked at where I thought the dragon was, and 2 smoldering black orbs looked back at me. I froze. As I squinted, I could see the orbs belonged to someone or something. The figure stood and revealed a tall and lanky frame swathed in the darkness. Its back was slightly hunched, with the right shoulder sitting higher than the left. The exposed right arm was drawn up onto its chest, the hand curled down with long, thick-knuckled fingers tipped with glistening black nails. The arm was covered in black feathers, making it seem like the wing from a raven. The head of the creature was deeply wrinkled and gray, with what looked like similar short, patchy black feathers poking up and flowing down the back of its neck. It had a long, crooked nose and sagging cheeks, and the skin under its chin was very loose. Its eyes, the black orbs, swelled with a darkness that drew you in and threatened to swallow you. The creature hissed and made a clicking noise, and I could smell something like rotting fish and death wafting towards me. As it moved from the corner of the room, darkness pulsed from it. I heard the scrape and scratch of clawed feet on the wooden floor. My eyes traveled down its body to feet that looked like that of a large bird, or maybe a dragon. It moved closer, its eyes narrowed. It knew I was awake. It knew that I could see it. The feathers on its head seemed to bristle and vibrate. The hissing noise that it made grew in what I assumed was agitation. The pungent smell grew as it bent down towards me, and I tried to scoot away, to make myself smaller. Its eyes shifted and head twitched from side to side, looking from me to my nightstand, to my pillow, and even the foot of the bed. It was looking for something. The eyes refocused on me and to the hand that I still clutched to my chest. My hand squeezed the blue satin bag hard enough that the tooth inside pinched painfully into my palm. Was this the tooth fairy? My hand shook as I slowly pulled it away from my chest and offered the satin bag to the creature. Its eyes followed the movement and scrutinized the offering. The gnarled right hand slowly reached out and plucked the bag, the black nails feathering over my skin. I winced at the stinging sensation it left, as though I'd been cut. The creature sniffed at the bag, snorting and wheezing, frantically trying to remove the tooth from within. Once free, my tooth seemed to glow between its gray fingers. As it opened its mouth, the rotting fish smell grew until I thought that I might be sick. I watched as a blackened, sticky tongue reached out to meet the fingers that descended towards its gaping maw. A second later, I could hear a crunching noise as it chewed. Seemingly satisfied with its meal, the creature delved into its shadowy clothes. The left hand that had been hidden at its side stretched out and dropped something onto my bed. I looked down to see the worn side of a dollar coin. When I looked up, the creature was gone. I never told my parents about the creature that visited me that night, or the nights that followed until I was almost 12 years old. I'm much older now, but the image of that creature still haunts me. I had tried everything from hiding the next tooth that I lost to leaving the lights on at night. Nothing I did stopped the creature from visiting after I'd lost a baby tooth. "Daddy, Daddy." I looked up to see a little girl with honey brown hair and lopsided pigtails bounding down the hallway from the bathroom. "I've lost another one," she said as she held out the little white tooth and beamed up at me to show the gap in her smile. "Hey, kiddo. Well, you know what you have to do, right?" I said. I handed her a red satin bag and she snatched it from me, dropping her tooth inside and pulling the drawstrings tight. Abigail knows about the tooth fairy. At least the version my parents chose to tell me. With each tooth that she loses, I lay awake at night, praying she'll never awaken and learn the truth. Sometimes I think I can still hear the scrape of its feet or the scent of rotting fish. I'm ashamed to admit it, but I'm grateful that it will never come for me anymore.